Hi there. In this video, I'm going to show you how I created this file right here that I stitched out on a sweatshirt where the curve of the lettering matches the curve of the neckline. So to get started, this is a little bit of a trial and error process, but to get started, first you need to kind of know how big you want this to be. In this case, let's just say my lettering was about 4 inches by 4 inches. So from this point to the far left to the farthest right, it's about 4 inches, and then it went up about 4 inches. So that should give me a sense of how big my letters were and how much of a curve I needed. Let's hop over to Embrilliance and I'll show you how to get that curve. First, you want to use your lettering tool. Then you're going to select the third button over here to do text on a curve. Next, you're going to choose your desired typeface. I used the Hollie Marie. Then I typed out my text. And I made it a little bit larger. Remember, overall, we wanted it to be about 4 inches wide. So I'm going to scale that up. And that looks about right. I actually made my R a little bit larger than the rest of the letters. So I'm going to double click on the R and I will scale that up just a smidge. And now I'm going to rotate everything overall. So I'm going to say Command A to select everything and then use this rotate button to get it to rotate. Now I feel like I need a little bit more of a curve, so I can adjust that curvature if I want to get the right curve. And I can actually move each of my individual letters around if I want to as well. But that kind of gets me close to what I want. I'm going to just take that R and make it a little bit larger and move it away from the rest of them. And that is more like what I created. Now, if you recall from the image, I also merged in a few little daisies. And this daisy design is free on my website if you want to head over there and grab it. But I'll just show you how I merged that in. So I am going to do File, merge the stitch file in, and I'll go and I'll locate it. It's thinking about it. All right, so this is located with all my embroidery designs and my free designs. Some weird looking things right there. All right, and the daisies, the little daisies. So there are a whole bunch of different versions. I'm just going to merge in the medium one, and how about the small one as well, and the large, and then I can use, oh, there's extra small too. So we'll just merge in the small and, oh, that'll be fine for now. And I'll say import. So I've got two different versions merged in. I'll take one, select one, and move it around. Okay. So that's basically how I set up that exact design. Now, it's probably not going to be perfect the first time you do it, and that is to be expected. What you can do, what I suggest doing, and what I did is, I'm trying to select this other one here. My head's in the way, I think. Let's move my face, and I'll select two and move that out of the way. So I just kind of move them sort of next to the name. Now, once you get it the way you like it, what I would do is I would say File and then Print, and then print out your design. And then lay it on the sweatshirt. And I actually trimmed around the edges there. And these hash lines too really help for placement. And I described that in greater detail on my blog. The other thing you should do, especially if you add these daisies, is you don't want to stitch it out blue, then white, then yellow, then white, then yellow. What you're going to do is you're going to go to your utility menu and do a color sort. Put it in a new view. And then you'll see that now your design is blue, then white, then yellow, which is a much more efficient way to stitch out this design. So that's how you lay out a curved neckline design in Embrilliance Essentials.